think also that the way you have built the album, as you say, the songs in themselves are more dynamic, perhaps, than the former.
Yeah,
also the album as a whole, if you think of it, like it's up there and then it slows a bit down in the middle, so we get a little break and relax and take a breath again, and then it's top again.
That's what I looked for when I grew up. I mean, you wanted an whole album to listen to, not just one song that is good. You want something more. You want the whole record to be something. So then it's gonna last much longer.
Yeah,
absolutely. That's something that's not so good with today's musical industry. Is they
get geared
towards songs, not albums. You know, if I put a song, if I hear Bullets to the Wall, I want to hear the whole album, not just the first song. You know, that's always the case.
That's the same as with Iron Maiden, as you mentioned.
Exactly.
I want to hear everything when I first started.
Exactly. So and people don't do it this way anymore. You know, the kids today, they just hear a couple of songs.
Take one song there and download another.
That, you need a single.
I don't like this. I mean, Spotify and all these web services are great if you just want to check it out, but many people stop there, you know. They don't go deeper into it, and we lose the well, I guess you could say fanaticism, but it's a good way, in a good way. When you are so interested, then you go and check the rest out. Many people don't bother anymore because you just get one song online really easy.
There is this, like on iPods, there is only one or two songs from every band.
Fuck that.
Yeah.
You don't pick a book and read just one chapter.
Exactly.
Yeah, chapter 9 and chapter 7.
They're really good chapters.
Yeah. I didn't read the first, you know, I didn't read the last three chapters of Harry Potter because I thought the shit was shit. So I don't know how it went. No, I see.
That's a very good analogy, actually. I never thought about it that way. But it's more or less the same. You know, don't read a couple of...
You didn't read the last one of Lord of the Rings, just the two first. Smart thing to do. Okay, I think we should close in, but I have a couple of questions which I need to ask. And one is, you covered Mascherona, the Knack track. Personally, I haven't heard the original version. How does it differ from the original, or does it differ?
Not much at all.
It's pretty much the same song, but of course this is a metal version, so it turned out really good, unbelievably good, I would say.
Yeah, if you consider what it was from the beginning, this is a good song, but it's the production of 1980. You can't compare that to 2008, especially not the production of Charlie Bauerfeind, our producer. So he really gave it a good metal feel. We didn't really change anything except for making the solo part in the middle shorter. We cut a little bit of that out because it was way very, very long. But apart from that, everything is exactly the same.
I thought about it. What if they put that song as number 4? How would the album be then? Yeah. Okay.
Well, that's an interesting point because the track list is something that gets overlooked a lot. And we always
take care of that.
Yeah, extremely important. It has to have a good feel. You can't have two songs that start with a guitar, a lone guitar, next to each other, because that will make it feel weird.
Yeah.
Two fast songs and then five slow ones. That will also make it feel weird. So like you said, it's an ebb and flow. Now you can bring it down with a ballad and take it up again afterwards. That's really important. It's more or less an art form as well.
But it's a cool ending because you ended the album, since this isn't the official.
Yes.
Yeah. It's like, you ended, I've heard a Hammerfall album, then I heard, this is not a Hammerfall song, I heard it at once, I didn't read it. I just heard, this is not a Hammerfall song, but it had a Hammerfall sound.
Yeah.
I had to smile when I.
It's a feel-good song.
Yeah.
It's a party song.
Party song for sure. It's that riff that it's very classic riff. You know, if you heard this song once, you can immediately recognize it. You know what it is because nothing else sounds like that.
it's kind of like this Led Zeppelin, Kashmir, which he also had this very trademark. So, but it's a nice ending for the album. It leaves you in a good mood and everything.
Yeah, it's supposed to be. If that's the last song you hear on the album, you get gold, feel good, you get positive, walk away doing things with it, because it's a very energizing song, and it was very very fun to play, even if it's very simple.
Yeah. Okay, my final question is of course about the album title. Here we go. No sacrifice, no victory. It makes me think. What is it that you want to win? What is the competition?
World domination.
Of course. Actually, this song title, you know the movie Transformers?
Yeah.
That's where we got it from. The dad of the main character guy always says to you, if you want to borrow my car, you have to wash it first. No sacrifice, no victory. If you don't sacrifice anything, you will never get anything. And I think that is an extremely important life lesson for everybody, young and old, basically, because you can go through your whole life getting everything served to you on a silver platter. You never know what it is like, what it's like to sacrifice something and then getting if you put the hard work in and then get the reward at the end, it's so much sweeter than just getting the reward. You know, the work, even if it's hard and sometimes boring, it makes you feel so much better about yourself. Like going to a workout, for example, you go there and thinking, oh, I don't have any energy for this. When you're done, it's like, fucking hell, I should have done this more. Because it makes you feel good, you know, you get adrenaline, you get everything, all the positive aspects from it. I think that is, it's not so much what we have sacrificed or what we will sacrifice, it's more of a general truth of life that I think people should... take notice of. I mean, if they haven't already.
So it's a kind of a competition against the self, simply put.
It deals with everything in life, I would say. Yeah. I mean, we have to sacrifice time and sweat and everything to make a good album, and that's what we get out of it. And we have to be in the rehearsal space and do our job to make a good show, and that goes for anything, I'm saying.
I guess the sacrifice, because it's funny that everybody who's talked about to me about this has ended this with, what have you sacrificed? You didn't say that, which is very good. But I think you could interpret it to back into the middle of the 90s when we did sacrifice our hip factor, I guess you could say, by doing something we believed in that was uncool, you know. It didn't really matter what people thought about it, but it's a great feeling that we did sacrifice for something we believed in, and then we got the victory in the end. I think that feels very good. Awesome.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.